Hi, in this lesson I'm going to be teaching you micro cuts by Muse. This is mainly difficult with the picking technique rather than finger position. So I'll start off by playing the intro and I'll teach you the rest of the song. So. So that, to start off with, that does that four times. I'm using an acoustic simulation and delay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn that delay off. Right. Oh, I've got some reverb in there as well. So the first sort of chord that you're going to be picking in is on starting off on the 12th of the D. And then barring across the bottom three strings on the 10th fret. And the picking pattern that you're going to be doing, so it's going D, G, B, E. So the strings that you're going to be picking are D, G, B, G. Then E, B, G, B. So together, you're going to do that four times. Then you're going to do it again, just once. Then you're going to change to a different chord. That goes like that's still on the 12th of the D. You're on the 12th of the G, 11th of the B, and 10th of the E. And you're going to do the same picking pattern. Next bit goes like this. So you're just going to be going D, G, B, E on as the first chord that you've learned. And then instead of the 10th on the G, you're just going to put your a finger in and do the 11th of the G. And then it starts off with the second chord you learn. But instead of stopping there, you're going to carry on and do another one. So. It's got an extra on the end. So you're just going to be going D, G, B, G, E, B, G, B, E, B, G, B again. And you're going to do that twice. So. And do that same extended pickup, picking pattern. With the first chord that you learn, and the last chord is this, and that is I keep barring across the 10th fret of the bottom three strings instead of having to move all the time. So working down from the D to the high E, it's 11, 12, 10, 12. Do that extended picking pattern there as well, and then back into the first chord again, and you're just going to be going D, G, B, E, D, G, B, E, and then the whole lot starts again. So I'll play it slowly with no delay. Thank you. And then that's the intro sorted. That's played at various points through the song. And then it comes in with a thick sounding guitar for the chorus. That's just muted. The song's in drop D, I forgot to mention. Sorry about that. So the first one, you get the first chord of the chorus, you're barring across the top three strings on the fifth fret. So the D, the A, and the D again. Playing open the D and A, and on the higher D, you've got your finger on the fourth fret. Back to the bar across the fifth fret. And on the third time you go to do it, you do the fifth fret on the bar across the fifth fret again. And then the end goes like this. That bit is it's all on the A, the D, and the G string. So going down from A to D, A to G, sorry, it goes 12, 12, 11. And then you're going to do a power chord shape on the working down again. You're going to go 10, 12, 12. Working down again, it goes 11, 12, 10. Bar across the 12 frets, so they're all on 12. And then goes 12, 11, 12. And then it comes in with the intro again, the picking pattern. Then it comes in with the chorus again, exactly the same, absolutely identical. And once you finish there, this comes in. That is the 5th fret on the A and 7th fret on the G. Mute out the D string in between and just keep bending and bending and bending. And then once that bit's finished, it goes like this. Quite a lot to take in, but it's all in the same shape. So after this bit, you're going to be using the same shape that you did that bend with, and you're going to be moving up from the 5th and 7th frets to the 8th and 10th, down to the 7th and 9th, then 5th and 7th, then 4 and 6. 2nd and 4th frets, 4th and 6th, and then 5 and 7th, then 9th and 7th and 9th, 8th and 10th, and then 9th and 11th. You can either carry on doing, or you can just bend the 11th of the G. And then the next bit, I hammer on, I'm on the 12th of the G, hammering on and pulling off the 13th of the G. Then it comes in with the 10th and 12th frets in the same shape on the same strings that you did before. Can't remember which notes I did. Right, yeah, I've got it now. So after the hammer, you're going to do the 10th and 12th frets, then to 9th and the 11th, then 8th and 10th, then 9th and 7th, back to the 8th and 10th, back to the 7th and 9th, stay on the 5th and 7th for a bit, then move to the 4th and 6th frets. And then the last half of that, you just mute out all the strings. And then it comes on with the end riff, which goes like this. Fairly simple as well. It's quite repetitive. So the notes for that are on the A, 5-4-3 open. Then on the low D now, it's 6-5-3 open. And then 3 open on the low D again. And then 3-5-7. Yeah. 3-5-6-7 on the low D. And then open. I think it's open. Open D, and then you're going to go back to the 3rd, 4th and 5th frets of the A. So slowly, I'll bring it closer so you can see what I'm doing. And that repeats over and over. The next bit, this bit, you've already learned that. You just keep doing the first part of the riff that I just taught you. Slide up to wherever in that and then the song finishes by just hitting the open strings. I think it's 4 times, I think it is. Yeah, but you just finish off with open strings. So I hope that was clear enough. I know it wasn't the best. I'm not brilliant at tutorials, but I hope you got the idea. I'm up for any constructive criticism. If there's anything wrong with it, just let me know and I'll do my best to improve it. So thanks for watching. Hope it helped.